I would like to welcome you to the United Church of Fayetteville's Candlelight Christmas Eve service. This is the season when we reconnect with family and friends, whether in person or in spirit virtually. We are glad to have you here to celebrate Christ's birth.
The world gathers once again to behold a child newly born. We hear the sounds of angels and follow shepherds. We see a birth star and follow its light. We hear a baby's cry and a prophet's call, and we follow to love and adore, to sing and to serve the Prince of Peace who is born tonight.
Thank you.
Please join me in our responsive Christmas thanksgiving. Most holy God, your glory bursts across the heavens. The sun and the moon, the stars that you have made, all shine down from the earth and the seas. Into the midst of this wondrous, swirling life, you chose to be born this night, a tiny baby, a vulnerable child, a savior for the world. As did the peoples of old, let us bring our gifts to the Christ child. We are called to follow him, not just through this night, but into the world in ministry. This night we dedicate our offering to the Fayetteville Manlius Food Pantry. Please pray with me. Wondrous God, still in the expectant hush, we listen for an infant's cry to break the silence. While we wait, we hear the echoes of other cries. The voices of our own children at their birth, a parent's tears at a wedding, and children's tears at a funeral, the cries of those who go to bed afraid. Then we hear a voice ring out into the night, one we've heard before and one we wait each year to hear. Knowing that a new thing has begun, we have a deepened faith that we are bound for a more joyous future with you. We brave the cold for a glimpse of the new life among us. We crowd around the manger with family and friends and strangers, the ones who will return to a safe, warm house, and the ones for whom this barn is a shelter. In the warmth of one another's presence, we experience a new sense of connection, a greater responsibility, and a higher hope. Our backs to the dark, our faces lit by the light of this life, when we see your image in every face, we can imagine new ways through this night and all the days ahead. For we know indeed that you are Emmanuel, God with us. We fall to our knees in speechless thanksgiving until the music of our souls rises to join the music of the spheres. We join our voices with the heavenly host in glorias that will fill our days for this and every day of vulnerable new life, quiet joy and light in the darkness. Accept our thanksgiving now and forevermore. Amen. A reading from Genesis, first chapter, verses 1 through 5, 14 through 19. God's word to us begins in the beginning. Let us listen. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the earth, covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs, and for seasons, and for days, and for years. And let there be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening and morning, the fourth day.
God's word to us tonight continues from the Gospel of John. Let us listen together. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave the power to become the children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of humans, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. May God bless our living of this Word.
Thank you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? The child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? And did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again, the lame will leap, the mute will speak the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am.
In the beginning was the Word, a word from God, the angel said, a word, then shadow, only darkness in her memory. And now this child, she could not remember when it had not been. Her fullness was the child, and her whole being was its fullness. It was as though it had always been the fullness of that word. On the donkey's back, her heaviness moved with a life of its own. Edges of darkness shifted, shadows drifted. Night creatures stalked, amber eyes lit from within. It was as though it had always been the darkness outside, the darkness within, the fullness of that word. Arching her back, face tipped upward, a thousand stars and the sickle moon glittering in the brittle night. Etched across the dome of the sky, they lit the heavens, even as the sun ruled the day in places she could only imagine and would never see. It was as though it had always been a world beyond her, and a world within her, the fullness of that word. Passing pilgrims or pilgrims passing by, all to Bethlehem, she heard them talking of great oceans where the light of life gleamed beneath the waves, deep forests luminous moss glowing in black woods. Travelers uttering strange names of star pictures painted across the heavens. Whispering of northern horizons that shone at midnight. Muttering of the world's end, its grim mountains full of fire. Light beyond her vision. Light inside her. The fullness of that word. At last arrived, the hard earth softer than the donkey's trot. The fire burned hot and high beside her. The time grew near, as she had always known it would. She closed her eyes and the stars blinked out. The fire, only embers now. She thought she heard the roar of oceans unseen. The world drew away. Nothing outside her. Everything inside her. Her fullness was the child, and her whole being was its fullness. Now the heat and the light of all creation gathered itself inside her. It was as though it had always been the fullness of that word. Finally, as she had known it would always be, the fullness of that word was thrust into being. And there was silence. Utter, complete stillness. All creation shuddered to a halt. Waiting. And the baby's cry rent the night. Wood on the fire, tongues of flame licking higher, sparks showering upward, tossing stars across the heavens. Creation trembled and found its way. Constellations steadied in their courses. Light spun outward in ever-expanding spirals. Horizons glowed anew with the lights of the night and the suns of the day. Dark places once again lit from within. She knew without seeing. It was as it had always been, the fullness of that word.
Thank you.
Christ has again indeed brought joy to the world. May we all know the blessings of hope, peace, joy, and love in this season and every season. And let us carry those blessings and share them with the world around us. And now, may the love of God, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.